Hi friends, welcome back. Today we are going to solve code forces problem game on leaves. Before we start looking into the problem details, some examples and the Java solution for this problem, I just want to mention that my channel is dedicated to help people who are preparing for their Java J2 interviews and for their coding interviews. On my channel, you will find lot of helpful videos that can help you in your Java interview preparation and for your coding interview preparation. You will find over 250 solved different varieties of coding questions which were previously asked in their interviews by big tech companies like Google, Facebook, Amazon, Apple, Microsoft, Yahoo, and many other big tech companies. And those are selective problems in the sense that they cover very important coding questions varieties such as DFS, BFS, matrix problems, dynamic programming problems, binary search tree related coding interview questions, linked list and string related different coding questions and optimization questions related to priority queues and lot of other questions as well. So this channel can definitely help you in your interview preparation. So please subscribe to the channel. So let's go through the game on the leaves problems description first, and then we'll go through some examples and we will formulate our solution. So basically there are two players, Ayush and Ashish, and they are playing a game on unrooted tree consisting of n nodes numbered from 1 to n. Players make the following move in turns. Select any leaf node in the tree and remove it together with any edge which has this node as one of its endpoints. A leaf node is a node with degree less than or equal to 1, right? Degree means how many edges are coming to that leaf, that node basically in the tree, right? So that is called as degree. So they are saying that in any move, the player can choose any leaf node, right, in the tree, and they can remove that leaf node. A tree is connected undirected graph without cycles, right? So we know that in tree there is no cycle, right? There is a special node numbered X. The player who removes this node wins the game. So in the tree there will be one node they will give us, and whoever can remove that node first is the winner, right? So Ayush moves first. Determine the winner of the game if each player plays optimally. So both will try to play optimally and they will try to remove the node, right? Whoever can remove that node first is the winner of the game. So that's what the problem statement is. So they have given us a couple of examples. I also created some examples on the whiteboard. So we will take some examples here. But before that, let's just quickly go through the order of the input that's given to us, right? So first thing is the number of test cases. So here number of test cases is 1. Now in the second line, means in the first line of a test case, right? Two integers n and x are given to us, which is number of nodes in the tree and the special node that we like the player will try to remove, right, to win the game. So in this example, for example, three nodes are there and one is the node that they are trying to remove, right? So let's just quickly draw one tree here so that we'll just go with this example and then we'll see some other examples. So there are three nodes, right? So that's given to us. So 2 to 1 and 3 to 1 are the edges. So let's just draw one tree here quickly. So this is 2 to 1 or 1 to 2. It's undirected, right, tree. And 1 to 3 or 3 to 1 edges are there. So these are the tree edges. So this is given to us. Now Ayush and Ashish. So there are two players, right? Ayush and Ashish. So Ayush is the first one who will start playing the game, right? So we have to one is the node that they are trying to remove, right? So one is the node that they are trying to remove, this node. So this node, since Ayush is the first player, he can remove, he can remove any node now which is leaf node, right? So let's say Ayush. So there are two players, right? Let's just call Ayush and Ayush A1, let's call, and Ashish A2, right? Let's say Ashish is A2. So Ayush will be first, he will get the first move, right? So he will either he can remove 2 or he can remove 3, right? Because these are the two leaves in this tree, right? But as you can see, whatever he removes, So let's say, for example, if he removes 2, right? Then after 2 is gone, then the tree will look like this, right? The tree will look like this, 1 and 3. So it means that always Ashish will win, right? Because he will get a chance to remove 1 now, because 1 becomes leaf now, right? So always Ashish will win. So as you can see, in the example here, Ashish is the winner, right? Ashish is the winner. So let's take some other examples, some bigger examples. So let's I created one big example where number of nodes are 6 and the node that they are trying to remove is 3. So 3 is the node that they want to remove, basically, right? To win the game. So let's just consider some like scenario where Ayush will start playing, right? He will, let's say he removes 1, right? Ayush removes 1, then Ashish comes. Ashish removes, let's say, because he cannot remove 2, right? Because otherwise, he is also playing optimally. So he will try to remove 6, right? So let's say he removed a 6. After that, Ayush will, let's say, Ayush will also be playing optimally. So he will remove 5, right? So Ayush removed 5. Now there are only 2 nodes left, 2 and 4, right? So whatever nodes Ashish removes, if let's say Ashish removes 2, right, then always Ayush will win, basically. Always Ayush will win this game, right? Even if it removes 4, Ayush will remove 3, right? Because 3 will become a leaf node, basically, right? After removal of 2 or 4, then 3, like, then in that case, let's say if he removes 2, then the tree will become like this, right? Just 3 and 4, right? Just 3 and 4. So Ayush can come and Ayush can remove 3 first, right? Then he will be winner, basically. You might have noticed that whenever, like, first thing is, let's say if there is a tree, let's say, right? If there is a tree where, let's say, 1 and 2 is there, right? Only 2 nodes are there. Means this, we will calculate the degree of every node in the tree, right? So degree of 1 is 1. And degree of 2 is also 1, right? Because there is only one edge which is coming to 1, basically, right? And coming to 2. So if that is the case, then always Ayush will win, right? Because whatever node is there, you know, it's trying to remove. If its degree is 1, it means that it is a leaf node. So he will be the first one who will be able to remove that leaf node, right? So Ayush will win always in that case if degree is 1. So this is one scenario. Now, another we have to consider the other scenario. Let me just remove this marking. So, other scenario is whenever you notice, you might have noticed that if n is an even number, basically, right? So, 6 mod 2 is equal to 0, right? 6 mod 2 is equal to 0. So, it means that the number of nodes is even, right? So, if that is the case, always Ayush wins. Always Ayush wins. And why that is true? Because I have just explained you from this example. This is where n is 6, which is even number. So in this case, Ayush will play optimally, right? In any case, whenever there is a even number, always Ayush wins, basically. So let's say, for example, let's just go again with this example, but this is very important point to solve this problem. So let's say Ayush comes, Ayush removes 6, right? Then Ashish comes, Ashish removes 1, right? Then Ayush comes, Ayush removes 5. Then Ashish comes, Ashish has now choice of 2 and 4. Let's say he removed 4, right? Then in that case, the tree will just look like this, 2 and 3, right? 2 and 3. Now, in this case, always Ayush can remove 3 basically first, right? He can remove 3 first because it's a leaf node now. So whenever there is a even number of nodes, always Ayush will be the winner. And if it is an odd number of nodes, then Ashish will be the winner. So let's take a look at the odd number of nodes here, right? So let's take a look at odd number of nodes. You can see that 5 is odd number of nodes here, right? Now this is, again, I created one tree. That is, let's say this input is given to us. So 1 to 2. 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 5. So this is the tree, let's say. And we want to remove this node, basically, right? We want to remove node 3. This node we want to remove, right? So again, Ashish and Ayush, right? So Ashish. So let's say Ayush. Sorry, Ayush is the first one, right? Ayush is the first one, and the second one is Ashish, right? Ashish. So Ashish is the second person, right? So Ayush will go first. He will try to remove any of this node, one or five, right? One or five, because he can only remove the leaf node, right? So let's say he removed one. Both are playing optimally. So now Ashish turn, right? Ashish will come. Ashish will try to remove, let's say, five, right? Because he is also playing optimally. Now only two nodes are left now, two or four, right? Two or four is the leaf node now. So Ayush will have to choose one of them, right? Ayush's turn is there now. So Ayush, let's say, choose two or four. In any way, three will become a leaf node, right? So the tree will become either like this after removal of four, or the tree will become like this, right? If he removes two. So in any case, three becomes the leaf node. So always Ashish will win this game when the number of nodes is odd, because Ashish will go and Ashish will now remove three here and here, both in both scenarios. So this is the concept and this is the logic to solve the problem. So let's go ahead and take a look at the Java code for this problem. So first, this is the input that is given to us. So n is equal to 6 and x is the node that is we are trying to remove. So we are trying to remove the node 3. So this is the example that we just saw, right? This is the example. So let me just remove this colors. So let's just do one more thing, right? Let's say, for example, you take any of this node. Basically, you take any node, then always if it is a even number, Ayush will win, right? So let's say one, right? So one means you can directly go ahead. Ayush can come and he can remove one, right? Let's say instead of one, X is number two, right? Number two is the node that we are trying to remove, right? So Ayush will come. Ayush will remove 6, right? Then Ashish will come. Ashish will remove 5, right? Ashish will remove 5. Then Ayush will come. Ayush will remove 4. Then Ashish will come. Ashish has no choice now, but he has to remove either 3 or 1, right? Now the tree is like this for Ashish. For Ashish, the tree is looking like this, 1, 2 and 3. So he has two choices now, right? Either 1 or 3. Whatever he removes, always Ayush can now come and remove number 2, basically, right? So always Ayush will win if it is even number, right? So we have seen for 2, we have already seen for 3. So let's take a look at 4 now. Let's say if the node, winning node is 4, whoever removes 4 first, right? So Ayush will come. So let me do one thing. So 4 is the winning node now. So Ayush will come, he will remove 1, right? Then Ashish will come, he can remove, let's say he can remove 6, right? Then again Ayush will come, Ayush will remove 2, basically, right? Now the tree will be 3, 4, 5, right? So Ayush has already removed. Now the tree is like this, 3, 4 and 5. So Ashish's turn. So Ashish can remove anything, like he can remove 5 or he can remove 3. In any case, 4 will become leaf node, right? And always Ayush will go and he will remove that node, basically, right? So always Ayush is the winner. So we have seen why it works. So same thing with 5 also and 6 also. 6 is directly, it's a leaf, so Ayush will directly remove 6. If it is 5 also, still applicable. So we can just, we have just one test, this node left. So we'll just do that also. So you will know. So let's say 5 is the winning node. Whoever removes 5 will be the winner. So Ayush comes. Ayush first removes 1. Both are playing optimally, right? So Ashish comes. Ashish removes 2. Then Ayush comes. Ayush removes 3, right? Now Ashish comes. Now Ashish has this tree, basically, right? Now Ashish has this tree. 4, 5, 6. So Ashish can remove either 4 or 6. Whatever he removes, the tree, the 5 will become a leaf node, and then Ayush will go and Ayush will remove 5, basically. So he will win it. So I explained you in very detail, I think. So let's just look into the Java code now. So we are seeing the same examples we have seen. X is equal to 3, number of nodes is 6, and these are the edges that we draw here. This is the tree. So first thing is we will go through all these input edges and we will calculate the degree of each of the node, right? And why we are calculating the degree? Because we know that if we can use that degree in our logic, right? If to understand if the node is a leaf node or not. Leaf node will always have a degree 1 basically, right? So for example, if you look at 1, its degree is 1, only one edge is there, right? Because it's a leaf node. But other nodes, for example, if you look at 2, it has 2 degrees, this edge and this edge, right? So its degree is 2. So that is not a leaf node, right? So that's why we have to first, we will first create a degree array and we will decide the degree of each node. And first thing is we wanted to check the node that we are trying to remove. You know, if its degree is less than or equal to 1, which means that it is a leaf node, then in that case, Ayush will win, right? Because he is the one who is moving first. So he will win, right? Because he can directly go and remove the leaf node. Now, as I explained you, if it is if number of nodes is even number, always Ayush wins. So I explained you from this example, number of nodes is even, always Ayush wins. If number of nodes is odd, always Ashish wins, right? Ashish wins. So this logic I explained you why it is the case. So we'll just append into our string builder. We created an instance of string builder. We will append Ayush, who is the winner in case of number of nodes is even. If number of nodes are odd, then in that case Ashish is always be the winner. Both are, because both are playing optimally, right? We'll just do sb.sub.string to output our result. So let's go ahead and execute this code. So as you can see, Ayush is the winner because number of node is even, right? So even if we change this to anything, let's say if change it to 2, always Ayush is the winner in that case. Or if you change it to 5 or in any node, basically always Ayush will win, right? So this is the example where we have number of nodes even, number of nodes even, right? Let's make it odd. So let's say we have only 5 nodes here, right? So 5 nodes means we will, let's say, remove this 5, 6, h. So the example will become like this. Now we have only 5 nodes. We are still trying to remove 3. 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5. So 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5. So this is the same example now we are looking. Now as you can see, number of nodes is odd, so always Ashish wins. So let's just go ahead and execute this code and make sure that it works. So n is 5, x is equal to 5. Let's see. N is 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, n is 5, right? N is 5 and x is 3. X is 3, let's make this 3. So Ashish will be the winner when it is 3, right? When it is 3, Ashish will be the winner. Let's say who will be the winner in case of let me remove these things. So in case of 3, we have seen. So in case of 1, Ayush will be the winner, right? So in case of 1, Ayush will be the winner, because as you can see, Ayush can just go ahead and directly remove the 1, right? It's a leaf node, right? Let's take a look at 2. So if it is 2 is the node that we are trying to remove, in that case, Ashish will win. Let's say why Ashish will win, right? So now we are trying to remove 2 basically, right? So first Ayush will go and Ayush will remove 5, right? This is the node that we are trying to remove basically, right? So first Ayush will remove 5, then Ashish will go, Ashish will remove 4. So now the tree will look like this, right? So Ayush and Ashish are done. Now the turn is Ayush turn, right? And tree will be looking like this basically. So 1, 2 and 3, right? 1, 2 and 3. And we are trying to remove 2. So if Ayush removes 1 or 3, always 2 will become a leaf node, right? In that case, so always Ashish can go ahead and then remove that 2. So Ashish will always win, basically. Always in the sense, in this case, he will always win, basically. Right? So let's take a look. So Ashish is the winner in this case. If we are saying 4 here, so fourth node we are trying to remove. In that case, Ashish is the winner again. So why fourth node? Let's take a look at that. Why fourth node we are? So fourth node we are trying to remove now, right? So in this case, first Ayush will go, Ayush will remove number 1, right? After that, Ashish will remove number 2. After that, the tree will look like this, right? 3, 4 and 5, right? So now turn, this is Ayush turn basically. So Ayush can remove 3 or 5. So whatever he removes, always 4 will become a leaf node, and then Ashish can go ahead and Ashish can remove it, right? So Ashish is the answer for number 4. So this is how we can solve this problem. So the important thing to solve this problem is this even logic, even odd logic, and then it also depends on, you know, like if it is already a leaf node, then always Ayush will win, right? If it is a leaf node, always Ayush wins. It doesn't matter if it is even or odd. If the given node that we are trying to remove, it if it is a leaf node, Ayush gets first chance, right? So he just go ahead and removes the leaf node. So this is the logic to solve the code forces problem game on leaves. So if you are new to my channel, there is a code forces dedicated playlist on my channel which has around 80 problems solved and explained with whiteboarding sessions and Java code and examples. You can go through those different varieties of problems. Also, there is another big playlist on my channel called as LeetCode and LintCode Solutions. Those problems are coding interview questions asked by Google, Facebook, Amazon, Apple, Microsoft, Yahoo in their past coding interviews, and they are very important in the sense that they cover important coding questions varieties that you can expect mostly in your interviews, such as BFS, DFS, matrix problems, dynamic programming problems, binary search tree related different coding questions, linked list and string related coding problems, optimization problems using priority queue, and many other varieties you can find there. If you like this video, if you find it helpful, and if you like the way it's created with whiteboarding session, examples and Java code, then please give it a like. Also subscribe to the channel. Your subscription to the channel is really important because that is the way the videos can reach to more people who need help in solving coding problems. They can see this video of solved coding problems and understand how to approach different varieties of coding problems using Java and what classes, what libraries, what APIs of Java to be applied on solving different problems. Goal of the channel is to help as many people as possible in their coding interviews and in their Java J2E interviews. There are also a lot of Java J2E related videos there, you know, which like frequently asked telephonic questions, how to answer those questions, architectural related videos, as well as design patterns and those kind of videos you can find very helpful in your interview preparation. So please, if you find it helpful, then please give it a like. And if you have any questions regarding the videos, then please put your questions below the description. I am going to give you the GitHub account link of this problem solutions Java codes. You will find a lot of Java code solutions for different varieties of problems on my GitHub account. You can use this link to check it out. Also share this video with your friends and colleagues, and thanks for watching this video.